Well, hello, everybody, and welcome back to Aero Nicely News. We are officially back, and I'm still Lenny Hernandez, and we are still bringing you all of the positive news stories from around Aero Senior Living Communities. But this time, we got a few surprises in store for you. I don't want to spoil too much, but we are talking on-site news reporting. We are talking Aero team member challenges. We are talking a brand new slew and crew of friendly faces bringing you all the positive news stories from around our communities. So don't you go anywhere and make sure that you tune in when we have episodes. Let's jump to it. Our first story of the day is about preventing illness. Now, while our entire country has been focused on the coronavirus, Aero hasn't lost sight of another threat to our health and well-being, the flu. And here to talk about what we're doing to keep our staff and residents safe from the flu is Derek Harris, Aero's Regional Director of Wellness. Derek?
Thanks, Lenny. Well, it's flu season again, and Aero recognizes the dangers that infectious disease can pose to seniors. It is why we've taken the precautions that we have during the COVID-19 pandemic. So, we also take influenza very seriously and hold our flu fighters vaccine clinics every year in every community. This year was no different. Pandemic or not, we made sure that residents and staff had the vaccinations that they need to stay free and clear of the flu this year. As always, we made it easy for everyone to get their inoculations by bringing a team into the communities to administer the vaccines. It was a quick and simple process for everyone, and we even made our commemorative Flu Fighters Band shirts for employees who participated. We encourage you to get out there and get your yearly flu shot. By getting inoculated, you are helping keep those most vulnerable safe from infection, and they thank you from the bottom of their hearts. Thank you to everyone who participated in this year's Flu Fighters event. It was a huge success, and we look forward to next year's. Back to you, Lenny.
Thank you very much, Derek, and thank you all, everyone out there, for doing your part in preventing the spread of the flu. For our next story, we're going to take a look back at the past few months and the journey that Aero Senior Living took us on as we navigated COVID-19. And many of you are probably familiar with the series that our company produced called Counting Down the Days. Well, those of you who aren't familiar, Aero partnered with a series of musical artists to make music videos that showcased what senior living looked like during COVID-19 and how we kept spirits high, counting down the days until we were able to see each other in person again. And those results were something beautiful and amazing. I mean, we were so lucky to be able to work with these amazing artists, kicking off with indie darling and keyboardist Misty Boyce singing Smile.
Light up your face with gladness. Hide every trace of sadness. Although a tear may be ever so near.
Continuing with Broadway singer Ellen Marie Marsh covering Somewhere Over the Rainbow.
Somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly, birds fly over the rainbow. Why then, oh, why can't I?
The ukulele girl of YouTube, Julia Nunes, covering Walking on Sunshine.
'Cause I just can't wait till you write me your coming around.
I'm walking on sunshine. Whoa, I'm walking on sunshine.
Folk artist Chris Matthews singing Hey Good Looking.
Say hey good looking, what you got cooking? How's about cooking something up with me? Hey sweet baby, don't you think maybe we we could find us a brand new recipe.
Portland-based acoustic artist Chris Parecki singing What a Wonderful World.
I see skies of blue and clouds of white, bright blessed days, dark sacred nights, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
And many other incredibly talented performances and artists before wrapping up the series with I'm Coming Out, performed by Jasmine Taylor and Adam Showalter. The series was at times sentimental, at times silly, but always was from the heart. We wanted to make sure that families knew that their loved ones were faring well during this pandemic and still living their best lives. We loved our series, but the countdown is now over. We have officially begun allowing people back into our communities, but there are still some strict guidelines in place. But families are returning and getting to visit each other once again. And to punctuate the reunions that we've been witnessing, we have partnered one last time with the musical talent Charles Glenn. Charles sang the national anthem for the St. Louis Blues hockey team for 19 years, and he just retired last year. But he has given us one last song to truly celebrate being together again. That'll do it for another episode of Arrow Nicely News. And boy, can I just tell you that it feels so good to be back here with you all. And we'll be back again in 2 weeks to give you more positive news stories from around Arrow senior living communities. So until then, I'm Lenny Hernandez, and this was Nicely News. We'll see you next time.
I'll be laughing and singing and records swinging and dancing
in the street,
Philadelphia, PA,
dancing in the street,
Baltimore and DC now.
Yes,
dancing in the street.